Hey, what's up everyone? This week we're going to talk about debugging tools in Xcode. And I want to show you a tool that's actually been there for quite some time, but I've only recently discovered just how useful this tool could be. So let's get started. I'm going to paste some code. As you can see, this code is pretty straightforward. I define an array of numbers, and then I take a random number from this array. And now let's say I want to debug my code in order to find out which value is actually stored inside the variable random number. So for this, I'm going to set a breakpoint on this line, and then I'm going to run my app in the simulator. So the execution of my program has indeed stopped. And if we take a look right here in the variables inspector, we can indeed see which value is stored inside random number because it's just being displayed. It's the value 3. But there are actually other ways that we could have found out about this value. For instance, we could have printed the value inside the console. So like this, PO random number. But there is yet another way to find out which value is stored inside the variable, and it's to use the quick look feature of Xcode. To do it, we simply select the variable and click on the little eye icon right here. And as you can see, this quick look shows some information about the variable. We have its name, its type, and its value. But of course, when you're dealing with a value as simple as a single integer, this quick look tool doesn't seem extremely useful because, as we've seen, there are other actually simpler ways to find out which value is stored inside a variable. But as I've recently come to learn, this quick look tool can be extremely useful when we need to debug a variable that holds a value of a more complex type. So let me update the code so that we will try to debug this time something a little bit more complex than a single integer. And as you can see, this time the variable I'm gonna want to inspect with my debugger is going to be of a much more complex type because this time my variable will be of type UIView. So let's launch the app and see how we can use the debugger in order to find out which view is being stored inside the variable random view. Before I start the debugger, let me actually show you what this view controller looks like. As you can see, we have 4 views being displayed in a vertical stack view, and so one of these 4 views is going to be randomly chosen and stored inside the variable random view. Now I'm going to once again set a breakpoint on this line, relaunch my app, and wait for the debugger to be triggered. Okay, so I'm going to start with the easy approach, which would be simply printing the description of the view to the console. So just like the PO command I have used earlier. And as you can see, even though we still get some useful information, for instance, the frame of the view or the text that's being set to the label, this is definitely much less straightforward than when we were dealing with an integer and the actual value of the integer was being printed to the console. And as I'm sure you have already figured out, this is of course where the quick look debug tool is going to come into play. So I'm going to click on this tool once more and we're going to see what's going to appear. And as you can see, this time we get a much more useful piece of information because we actually get to see what the view looks like when it is rendered on the screen. And from this information, it's of course much easier for us to know which view is being stored inside the variable random view. And by the way, we don't even need to go into the variable inspector right here to see the quick look of a variable. We can just hover over the variable, then click on the little quick look icon. And as you can see, we also see the quick look preview being displayed. So we've seen just how useful this quick look debug tool in Xcode can be whenever we need to debug code that involves UIKit objects. But what might be even better is that when it comes to our own objects, we actually get to decide what the quick look debug tool should display. As you can see, I've implemented a class that models a simple game of tic-tac-toe. I have an enum for the 2 players. As you can see, each player has its respective symbol. Then I have a struct that records the move of a given player at a given coordinate. And finally, my class tic-tac-toe is going to store an array of moves. Now I'm going to go back to the code of my view controller. And inside the method viewDidLoad, I will paste the code to create a game of tic-tac-toe and have the player play a couple moves each. Now I'm going to once again set a breakpoint and launch the app. And as you can see, if I try to do a quick look over my variable tic-tac-toe, I do get some information, but nothing that is going to immediately help me understand what is the current state of the game. And in order to make this information about the current state of the game easily accessible, we are going to implement in the class tic-tac-toe the method needed in order to return some custom value that will be displayed by the quick look debug tool. And this is the method that will be called by the debugger in order to retrieve the information to display in the quick look preview. So here, what would I want my method to return? If we were implementing a real tic-tac-toe game, we would probably have a UI view that would display the state of the game, and so we would instantiate this UI view, set it with the current state of the model, and return this view. However, in my small project, I do not have such a UI view, so I'm going to return the next best thing, which is a textual description of the state of the game. So this is what this textual representation looks like. I define a 3x3 matrix of strings, and then for every move that was recorded, I simply update the string stored at the given coordinate in my matrix. And finally, I add some formatting to my matrix by adding vertical and horizontal separators. And then all that's left for me to do is to return the actual information that will be displayed by the Quick Look Debug tool. And so I want this tool to display first the content of my array of moves, then two blank lines, and then my formatted grid, which is the visual representation of the state of the game. So now let's relaunch the app and actually see how this is going to look like. I'm going back to the code of my view controller. I am once again setting a breakpoint and I'm going to relaunch my app. Okay, so the execution of my program has been stopped. So I'm going to go in my debugger, select my variable tic-tac-toe, and then I'm going to click on the Quick Look Debug tool. And as you can see, we indeed get exactly what we were expecting. So first, we have a console dump of the content of my array of moves. And then, even more helpful, you can see here, we have the visual representation of the state of the game. And as you can imagine, if we actually had to debug a real issue with the implementation of a tic-tac-toe game, having access to such a visual representation of the state of the game would be a tremendous help because it would enable us to understand at a glance what would be the current state of the game. And that's all I wanted to show you in this video. If, like me, you had never been a big user of the Quick Look Debug tool in Xcode, I'm pretty sure that after seeing these two useful cases, you're going to start using it a little bit more in the coming weeks. Thank you for watching the video and see you next time.